everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Up next, we've got what should be an intriguing matchup between the Cleveland Browns and the Miami Dolphins. With that, let's get down to Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. Standing by for the call, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Coach, thanks. Located appropriately for his career win total at 347 Don Shula Drive, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami, Florida. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their Dolphins emerging from the Hard Rock Stadium tunnels, and we're ready to go as the Dolphins get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. Brandon Godden, Charles Davis with you from our broadcast perch. And Charles, as we get this thing started, what are you going to be keeping your eye on?
Special teams. Field position is always a big determiner in a ball game. Who sets their offense up for success the best? That team will win the game.
Here's Jason Sanders now to get this one started. And we are underway from Hard Rock Stadium. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. They will be led out by the Heisman Trophy winner from 2018 from Oklahoma, Baker Mayfield. First carry now. This is Johnson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Mayfield with a quick fire to Landry. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
This one quickly into the hands of Landry. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Let's meet the offense, Greg Robinson. Very, very talented.
What a man to set your offensive line with. Greg Robinson can do it all. Tremendous athleticism, great strength, just coming into his own.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And the catch made by Johnson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 48-yard line. First carry for Nick Chubb. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. And let's run through the Dolphins' defense.
One of the more underrated yet valuable positions in the NFL is safety, and Rashad Jones epitomizes what you're looking for. A guy who can drop down into the box in the run game and tackle those bigger, stronger running backs. He can also cover people, whether it's tight ends or bigger slot guys, and that gives him the ability to stay on the field every down and make big plays.
They go with Chubb on second down. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Following the penalty, Chubb. And this time they're able to bottle him up as he'll stop him at the line of scrimmage. Devon Gancho up to make the tackle.
Being strong up the middle is imperative. I don't care what your sport, but in football, when you've got a D-tackle who can contribute not only to occupying bodies, but also making plays on the ball carrier, that's when you have the cornerstone of a solid run defense.
Mayfield hands it off to Chubb. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
That's why the guy with the headsets is down there. All right, they know what they're doing because they got stuffed on a running play on first down. And I think myself and probably the fans were saying throw the football in this situation. But he knew what he was doing, called another run, and now they've got 3rd and short.
Third and short yardage, Mayfield. And he's got his man, that's Landry. That'll be enough to keep the drive moving forward. Another first down on the pickup of 5 yards. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. It'll be a loss of 1, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11. Plays like that, when you see the athleticism of a guy over 300 pounds, you forget that they can do that. It's so athletic.
Yeah, and I love how it all came together. He won the leverage battle at the line of scrimmage. Then he won the battle with his hands to shed the blocker. And how about the agility to get into the backfield and run him down?
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's 2nd and 11. Throwing, Mayfield. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. Defensively, they better figure something out. Opening drive, he already has 4 catches.
And if you have to figure out how to stop him defensively, that usually means you weaken your defense. That means that now the offense is doing the dictating, and they should have other things open up as well.
Mayfield from the gun on 3rd down. He'll get this to Chubb out of the backfield. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11.
That was well defended, and while it was a completion, it resulted in a loss of yardage. It's really, really hard for a running back to think to himself, I probably should have just dropped it and saved the yardage. It goes against the entire training that he's had his whole career.
Fourth down, and on is Greg Joseph for the Browns field goal. The kick by Joseph is good, and the Browns are out to a 3-0 lead. A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle, right? No big plays given up, no balls over your head. Bend. Don't break.
Hold on. Chestnuts?
You like that one?
What does that mean, break out? Just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
Joseph now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here come the Dolphins now as they get set to take over on offense. Leading them out is going to be their quarterback. That's the grizzled vet, Ryan Fitzpatrick.
One thing that I think Ryan Fitzpatrick doesn't get enough credit for is his toughness. This is a guy who plays through injuries, but it's also being mentally tough. Knowing that everyone's always trying to move him out of the lineup, trying to find a replacement for him, yet he continues to battle and has earned the total respect of his teammates.
Running, it's Drake. Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
That's what I'm talking about.
The look now at the Miami offense.
I remember when Laramie Tunsil was coming out of Mississippi and I was evaluating him for the draft in 2016. Ended up writing down a description that I tended to like, and I'm going to use it here now. He's got feet like a receiver. He's got a body like an offensive lineman and hands like a boxer. Put it all together, you got a heck of an offensive lineman.
You better be afraid of me.
On second down, it's Drake. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield to run up there and make that tackle, setting a tone early for his defense.
And for the Browns, a nickel set here on third down.
You don't want none, baby. You don't want none. Hey.
Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick going deep here for Stills. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
On fourth down, Matt Hawk is on to punt. Back deep for the Browns, Antonio Callaway. Fielded just inside the 20. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at the 40. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. He's going to let this one go deep. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. The Pro Bowler Odell Beckham, the intended receiver. And now it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the gun, Mayfield. He finds Beckham complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. They convert on third with a gain of 22. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield over the middle and into the hands of his receiver Landry. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Running from the gun, Johnson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down. So third down, they need to get to the 28 for a first. You ain't doing nothing today. What? Mayfield to throw it. He finds his target, Beckham. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 18.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
Mayfield now 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys at first and 10. Mayfield throwing quickly out to Beckham. So a good spin move there before he's taken down. A nice little gain. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
On second and very short, Mayfield. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Xavier Howard.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. And now the starting defense for the Browns.
Olivier Vernon is a defensive end that combines terrific run-stopping ability with a quick first step to the passer.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. Throwing again. Fitzpatrick, that's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he'll be upended after a gain of five, up to the 25-yard line.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
The last play on the completion got him half of what they needed. Now here's a tough third and five. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. And he will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. In for the sack, Myles Garrett. Nothing after one on EA Sports. Here's Matt Hawk now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And when he it's said and done. It's a 58-yard punt, and that will come the offense as they take over. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. A run for Nick Chubb. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Chubb, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result, because what you're doing there, you mentioned the counter, you're using your offensive linemen sometimes to pull or move to influence the defensive front to go in that direction and create the space back in the other side and block it appropriately. But you're exactly right. Didn't move him, sat there waiting for him and made the play.
Chubb. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. And that led to a really nice game.
On first and 10, Mayfield. It's caught by OBJ. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. A good pickup there for the Browns, 15 yards.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Mayfield down. It's caught. Beckham. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Second and five after the 5 yard completion on first down.
Check.
Now Mayfield. He's got a man wide open. It's Landry. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Jarvis Landry. 27 yards. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Greg Joseph on for the extra point. And oh, it's blocked. And now the Dolphins have it. Does the big boy have the juice? He's at the 50. But he will not be able to bring this one back, and the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I know it's easy to kind of shrug off a blocked extra point, but this game is shaping up to be a tight one. The second half, this could prove crucial.
Yeah, we might look back on this one. We'll have to wait and see. Back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This is taken at his four. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all, and let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
A gain of three, second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
By 20!
53 at the mark. You want this?
And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Give him 12 yards there, and the Dolphins have a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
Play fake. It's Fitzpatrick. Escapes the sack. Now Fitzpatrick hit. It's out. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Browns. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return for a Browns TD. And give some kudos to the defensive coordinator, I think, here. They bring the blitz, they dial it up, and it turns into 6 points for them.
It's so nice to hear you actually give kudos to the defense. It is so nice to such an offensive guy like that. I love it. He dialed things up, and boy, a big play resulted for his guys.
Well, you like the credit to the defense there, right, my friend?
Yeah, do I ever.
Joseph on for the extra point. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This fielded at the two. A marker down. He does get it up past the 25. Will it hold? Let's see.
Defense.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Automatic first down.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense. First and 10. Running from the shotgun with Drake. Olivier Vernon brings him down.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so that can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down.
Play 20!
58's the mic. Pick it up, guys. Pick it up. 58, boys. 58. 58's Mike. I'm here all day.
Off the play fake here. Fitzpatrick. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 42.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes and that was it. Now you can run anything and catch the ball as we just saw there.
On first down, Drake. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. This defense, tough to run against. And those linebackers, they'll go side to side up the field, and there they get them for no gain.
If you can't get linemen upfield to the second level to occupy them, they have a field day just running to the football and putting ball carriers on the ground. Not many yards after contact when they wrap up like that.
Throwing on second down, Fitzpatrick. On the right side open is Gesicki. And now a fumble. The ball's out. And this is picked up by the Browns. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. He didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, let's just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. So we've got a challenge. Our referee's going to take another look on the tablet. He's going to be watching to see if the knee was down prior to the ball coming out.
Oh, I love what you just said there. You nailed it, because if the ball's shifting or moving before the knee or any other part of the body hits the ground, then that'll be considered a fumble.
Fitzpatrick on first down. Able to shake him off. And he's taken to the ground, but he was pulled down by the face mask. Here come the flags. And I believe this is going to be a first down. So that one will be accepted.
Automatic first down.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Now Drake. And he's eaten up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16.
But he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much. On second and 9, Fitzpatrick, it's complete to Drake. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and they're going to have a third down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. The kick by Sanders is good. And they'll at least get on the board here, still trailing, but 16-3 now. So they recovered the fumble, but ultimately could not take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put six on the board, ended up settling for three.
To the field goal. Here comes Sanders to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. There's Baker Mayfield as he and the Browns offense comes back out. He's got the lead here in the second quarter. He's thrown the touchdown, but also an interception. As a quarterback, does that interception, even though you're playing while your team's got the lead, does that always stick in the back of your mind a little bit?
For the best ones, it just upsets them that they did that because they don't think there should be any blemishes on their record. They think that they're way better than that. So your confidence gets tested a little bit. Being able to go back out there, maybe throw another touchdown, that'll tamp that down in a big way.
Yeah, because he's looked pretty good to this point. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
I got you.
Here's Mayfield. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. And they'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And he's got his man. That's Landry. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. He needed a yard. That's what he got. And it's going to earn him a new set of downs.
But we're used to seeing the guy that you consider the number one receiver double covered. But how about this guy? He's double covered and finds a way to make the play for a first down.
That's how you increase your Madden rating, right?
No doubt about that at all. And you know something? I think we'll hear about that from him soon.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now, rather than risk anything, Mayfield here, he's going to call a timeout as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Field on first down. Screenplay, Johnson. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield. A really nice pickup.
A first down throw for Mayfield. He gets this one to Johnson. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one. Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Mayfield off the play fake. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way. A dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. Mayfield looks to throw, and that is incomplete.
Trying to get that one to his tight end, and they've been trying to get the ball to him, but as of yet, unable to successfully complete one. But you know, there's usually a nice comfort zone in throwing to the tight end. Great sight lines, usually right in the middle of the field.
On fourth down, the Browns hand things over to the veteran Britton Colquitt to punt. He gets this away. It's a good one, drawing toward the sidelines. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. He has not had the game that he envisioned. His team has not had the game that they've envisioned here. So how do they turn this around now?
Well, right now, what he's looking forward to doing is finding a way to get the added weight on his back. Is it like that monkey that Steve Young was talking about? Remember that in the Super Bowl?
Oh, the 95 Super Bowl.
Right, when they beat the Chargers, and, you know, he had that weight of expectations and past greats on his back. In this case, it's just bad play. Can he shake it off and then be able to play loose and free and help his team out?
See if he can do just that. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he will perhaps get back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. And time has run out on this first half. So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As we go up to Orlando now and hand it over to Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taken at his four. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Here's a second and five now from the 25. Right back to Drake. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. And he finds Stills complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. On first down, Drake. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
From just shy of midfield, Fitzpatrick, and his throw is incomplete. He was trying to get that one to Kenny Stills, and it's third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Working out of the gun, Fitzpatrick. Now Fitzpatrick hit, it's out. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Browns. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. The pocket collapsed around him. I know we talk about it a lot, but a QB has to have that sixth sense, doesn't he?
He really does. And I know of one team at one point was training their quarterback with that time frame, and anytime he didn't get rid of the ball within the right amount of time, they would blow a horn or blow a whistle to show him this is what that time is, just what you're talking about, training him to understand this is the amount you have, make sure the ball's gone. Didn't happen in this case.
Here's Nick Chubb as they try to fire up this run game. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 and a first down. The running game fully in sync, 1-11 on that play.
And sometimes it comes from the offensive coordinator, understanding what he thinks the defense is going to do and dialing up the perfect play. Sometimes the quarterback, though, can look at the defense, realize he needs to change it to a run, and that gets it done in a big way as well.
They run again on first down, Chubb. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
On second down, Johnson. And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still had the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Mayfield from the gun on third down. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. Antonio Callaway there to make the grab. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit, get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, being on the second half, no matter what. Well, this first 5 minutes, first three, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that extra, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Joseph now to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Dolphins offense now heads back on the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
To throw again on second down, Fitzpatrick. And he's got his tight end. It's Mike Gesicki. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. First down, it's Drake. And he's going to take this across the 50 into Browns territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
They stay on the ground with Drake. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And just like that, it's third down. After seeing that, maybe time to go back to some downfield throws here.
Yeah, anything, change it up, because the teams that win, the best teams, they're the ones that make adjustments. Doesn't mean you can't come back to what you thought you could get done. Sometimes when you open things up a little bit, you can get back to what you wanted to do before.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. From the shotgun, it's Fitzpatrick. They're able to locate Wilson. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 36. This quarterback now, 5 straight completions here in this second half, 1st and 10. Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Kalen Ballage. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd and 11. Continues to be a struggle for this offense, and this home crowd, they're growing a little restless here in the second half.
And I think they've just got to look at how they're trying to move the football. Yeah, you want to run it, but maybe you spread it out, maybe some swing passes that can take the place of runs and give you a little more space.
180! Check 53. I got you, punk.
Now a draw play with Drake. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. No gain that time, but it leaves him with 3rd and 11 coming up. No gain on play.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times, and what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
Defense wins championships,
man. On third down, Fitzpatrick. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
This has kind of been the story all night long, hasn't it? An inability to really get much done on third downs, and it's costing them.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This from 54 yards away. And no, it doesn't get there. Hits the crossbar, bounces back out. He had it online, but it comes up about a rotation short. Well, he had that one on target. That's half the battle. The other half of the battle, however, is distance.
And he nearly had that, too. But it was the crossbar that said otherwise, and that'll deny him a shot at three.
Here comes the Browns offense back onto the field. So after the missed long field goal attempt, this offense set up nicely at the 44-yard line. First down, Mayfield. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Not his best throw there, but where we sit right now in the third quarter, he's had a pretty good game throwing the football.
He certainly has, and it's not exactly at the point where we're doing four-minute offense yet, but they've got to think about, I'm not going to say milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. On the carry, it's Chubb, and he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything that warranted a flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. So out of bounds on the punt, and the spot will be, the side judge says, right at the 35-yard line here. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there, we've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Mike, right 80! 53, Mike. Watch QB draw!
They'll keep it on the ground. Drake. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. To throw is Fitzpatrick, and he hits Drake. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. That's good for 9 yards as they convert on the third down play. This quarterback now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. They'll run with Drake. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Defense.
Face mask penalty. And Charles, you were a defender. You know sometimes in the heat of the moment, it's hard to keep your hands away from that face mask.
Sometimes you just get out of position as a defender when you're trying to make a tackle. So you end up flailing away and your hand gets into the wrong spot.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Here's Fitzpatrick. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Second down, looking to throw, Fitzpatrick. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 14. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10, and they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. But we'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On first down, it's Drake. And the stop will come inside the five at the four. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
So not quite a first and goal just yet as they come up now second and inches. Balaj. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable, and you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to see?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. The Dolphins on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now Fitzpatrick. Yeah, he's got it. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's 1st and goal.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
They come out here in the eye. 1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Fitzpatrick. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Here's a run with Balaj, and he is in. Touchdown, Miami. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Dolphins are able to cut into this lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And he's got it. That makes our score now 22-10.
A 10-play drive that time, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Browns offense heading back out to take possession. Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. The running game continues to be a big part of their success here early in the fourth quarter.
And with those types of runs, that tells you they feel very confident in their running game. They feel very strong at this stage of the contest, and they want to keep doing exactly what we saw there, running the ball down their throat.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys.
On the ground, it's Chubb. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. So the solid run on first, and I would imagine no real hurry to run that second down play.
No, it's all on your quarterback now. He's going to keep an eye on the play clock and bleed things down, and he's not going to let the ball be snapped until it's inside 3 seconds left on the play clock. Unless, of course, you're playing a video game, you're trying to run it up on your friend.
Nice touch. Cold-blooded, too. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be 3rd and about a foot or 2.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
Check.
They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up 4th down. His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
Here's Britton Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Cleveland. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. And a missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up.
And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. The D-tackle Sheldon Richardson came barreling in for the sack.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing 2nd and a bundle. To throw, Fitzpatrick. And this one incomplete.
Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
The Dolphins on third down, not quite 50%, 4-for-9. This will be a tough third and 18. From the gun, it's Drake. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. He gets a good chunk of yards there, 8 all told, but they're still looking at a fourth down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job, got off the field, brought the punting situation, so they're turning the ball back over to their offense. You think those guys would get along very well right now? Of course they will. Defense helped the offense. Now it's their turn to take it downfield.
Now Fitzpatrick on fourth down. And no, it's incomplete. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. On first and 10, Mayfield. Oh, he finds his running back who snuck right down the middle of the field. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. A 20-yard touchdown. And the Browns are going to tack on to their advantage. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. Joseph now to have the PAT. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. A nice, tidy little drive there, getting the ball in excellent field position, and only one play to score it. Joseph now to kick this one away. This is taken at his 4. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. 19 yards there on the catch and run. Decent start to the drive, but let's face it, they need a lot of things to go right in a short amount of time down 3 scores.
Yeah, they're going to run their 2-minute offense here in this game, but this is for future games. Can they get better and be ready for the next time, hopefully with a chance to win?
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. From the gun, Fitzpatrick. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Operating from the gun, Fitzpatrick. It gets it into the arms of Parker, complete. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and it'll be second and 12. Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Here we go, D. They'll throw again, Fitzpatrick. And that'll be incomplete. Albert Wilson, the intended receiver there. And that takes us from second to third down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden the secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
On third down, Fitzpatrick. Open man, it's Allen. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Dolphin first down.
As far as tight ends go, this guy's not a speed burner. He's much more of an inline blocking type of a tight end. But how about this last play? Made a nice catch and picked up a first down.
That's what impresses me about him. When he's called upon, usually gets it done. Fitzpatrick now to throw on first down. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down. Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up. They haven't been on the same surface tablet that you look at on the sidelines. Nothing's worked for them. They've got to find a way.
Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sack back at the 29. Miles Garrett able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
Remember, throughout my career here in defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. So now after the sack, third and long, and Fitzpatrick and company a little work to do. Third and long for Ryan Fitzpatrick. And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. He's going to let it fly. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And this Browns defense stands tall. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it.
taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Charles Harris, it'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sack.
Quarterback gets hit.
Imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay.
Game offense.
And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back 5.
Still second down.
They run. Chubb. And he's able to get out to the 32. Brought down there. And they get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. I was pretty surprised there when they lined up to run it on second and long, but it worked out for them.
It certainly did, and that requires some confidence, some fortitude, and a little bit of hope, doesn't it? You hope you catch the defense just right and break off a big run to help yourself out on the next down.
And again, it's Chubb. Yeah, he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. Give him 3 yards there as that'll take us to fourth down. So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And it was Baker Mayfield who led the way, the number one pick in 2018. He showed why he was so coveted.
And it was interesting because you remember headed into the draft in 2018, the projections on where Baker Mayfield was going to go, it varied. But rarely did anyone suggest he would go number one overall. And he did. Showed exactly why. It's not just how he plays. It's not just his arm and his vision. It's the leadership, it's the toughness, it's the moxie that he exhibits, and his teammates just feed off of it.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. From South Florida, good night, everybody.